Hey guys, what's going on? So this video, we're gonna try and explain these graphs on the Granatelli test and what we are seeing with the horsepower difference. So my apology, I got this video out quick and I just did a lot of editing and I was getting pressure. I wasn't ready to upload it. I had a lot of stuff going on. I just got back from a 3-day mountain bike trip, so I knew nothing was gonna get done then, and that's when I posted on my trip. I did a bunch of cutting. So let me just go back and explain, because a lot of things went on in this video. So let's just take a step back and say thanks to my new subs, guys. Thanks for subscribing to the channel. And so anyways, we'll get to the graphs. I'll try and explain them a little bit better so you guys can understand. So there's two things going on. We're gonna talk about first the Granatelli coil pack test, okay? We'll talk about it, then we're gonna show the graph, okay? What we netted out for horsepower, 3 more horsepower gain on the stock coil packs over the Granatelli. And then there was some increased torque numbers, and I'll tell you exactly what they are. Let me just, again, check the graph real quick because I don't have the number in my head, and we'll tell you what that is, and then we'll look at the graph and I'll try and explain that. So again, getting back to the numbers. 3 horsepower more on the stock coil packs, okay? So the numbers were 403 Granatelli, 406 the stock coil packs. For the torque, increase in torque, there was a 6 foot-pounds of torque increase. 338 was the stock coil packs, and 344 was the Granatelli coil packs. Now that's across, you know, your average across the whole graph. We'll look at the graphs right now. Okay, for the numbers, stock coil packs, horsepower, 406, and that was at basically 7,500 RPM, 338 on torque. For the Granatelli packs, 403 and horsepower, 344 on torque. So what we saw is for the torque, Granatelli is above the stock, and this was a spread here. I don't remember the numbers exactly because I had to draw some extra lines for the graph. So I kind of estimated about 300 here. Excuse me. 300 would be about in the middle. That's above the middle. So maybe like a 305 and maybe just above the 324. So I don't know, roughly 20, maybe a little more than 20 spread right here. But as you grew, or as you went up the graph, those two started getting closer together, then they became one right about the 50, just after 59, no, right about 5900 RPM, maybe 6000 RPM, they became one. So the increase overall, this curve, we saw again the difference of 6, the difference between these two, 6 foot-pounds of torque. Likewise, the red line, as it's climbing, it converges roughly above 54, maybe 5500 RPM, and they just kind of became one. This is Granatelli, this is stock, 3 more horsepower. All right, now this is where the confusion comes in. All right, now what you're looking at here, this 449, this is my dyno in 2000, I think it was 20, okay? 449. Now, this recent dyno, we got a 406. The difference between these two numbers mainly is the caliper transmission. So the caliper sucked 43 horsepower out of this car. Okay? Turning nose, stronger components, the billet steel gears, obviously they're heavier to take more horsepower and torque. So that is what you're seeing here, the difference. So the dotted line is my first dyno, full bolt on. Everything is the same, basically. What made the difference is the caliper transmission. So as you can see, we got quite a bit we lost in going to this caliper transmission in a car. Huge. And now this is extremely disappointing. So when you guys saw this graph, you're thinking the car gained from the, no, this has got nothing to do with the coil packs. We took our best dyno number off of this graph, which is a stock coils, the 406, a 338, 406. We laid them over our first dyno test on, not our first, but for our full bolt-on. Again, this is still a full bolt-on car, E85. We made 406, yeah. This is almost stock numbers on a Boss 302 without any mods done to it. So this is what's going on, and this caliper really sucked the life out of this car. So that was a shocker to me, a big shocker. So hopefully this clears things up for you guys around the questions, okay? So my bad for not doing a better job presenting in that previous video. Again, Granatelli coil packs made 3 less horsepower. They did make some more torque, but it wasn't huge. Now, did the transmission skew the test? I don't know. It's possible. It's possible, but I doubt it, because if it's gonna show anything, it's gonna show how it's sitting, but you know, who knows? The other thing we looked at, again, it's really a greater number than what we're seeing today, because our air was good. We had good air, 55 degree temperature. We had low humidity, low altitude, versus the 449. It was an 80 degree day. It was 2,300 feet altitude versus 770. And we kind of went through that. And we had a higher humidity. So, yeah, it's a big hit, a big hit. On this car. So our next steps, if you're wondering, is I'm just kind of planning it out, trying to decide what we should do and which way we should go. It's becoming winter time. We're gonna be storing this thing anyways, but I need to come up with a plan for this car, because I'm not gonna do heads and cams on this setup. I don't even want this setup, because you know, this is for high horsepower cars, so lots of boost. Whether you're you know, running turbos or superchargers or nitrous, this transmission was designed to hold 1,000 horsepower, 900 foot-pounds of torque. And to do that, you're using robust, you know, internals, your whole gear set, obviously much heavier. So, you know, it is what it is. We can't do much about it, but it's a watch out for you guys out there with NA cars. You want to go to calipers. In my opinion, I hate this transmission. I hate it to death. There's guys out there that love it. So, I just got hit up for it to ask if I'm still selling it. And, if I can, I will. The other plan is do a gear set change and maybe get back to a gear set in between and keep all those components that are in there, with the exception of the gear set, because then you still have an upgraded transmission. So anyways, guys, that's it. And don't forget to like and subscribe, and thanks a lot. Thanks for watching, and have a great day. Take care.